Hello, it's Sarah, and I am back for part two. You know what? I think my camera's crooked, right? Maybe like that. Oop, sorry. Okay, so what I have done so far is gotten part one, we did the background and base coated everything, and now we're really to the tail end details. Which is all the outlining and, you know, putting in the finishing on the houses. First, we're going to do the angel. We're going to do her. I didn't like how my hair was, so I repainted it. Going to give her curls, I think. I feel like giving her some curls. Oh, change your water. If you're going to do this, have clean water, because we're going to do a wash of color. And that is basically water with a little bit of pigment added into it, so you really need your water to be clean, especially since we're using white. I'm just going to shade, get some shading on here. It's probably too much, but anywho, push it up a little. All right, so that is fine. So the first thing we're going to do is just like, I think I'm going to use a flat brush like this size, like this is a number 10 flat brush, and the idea is we're going to make the wash. You make it first, which is just by adding a little bit of white paint to a little water puddle, then clean off your brush and just go straight into that wash that we make, and just in one kind of consistent coverage, cover the angel. You don't want to keep pitty-patting in it because you'll pick it up, and it'll look different on this canvas surface anyway than it would look like on a smoother surface. But it's basically going to be, it's going to be a very sheer wash of white, and we'll only see the undercoating of the blue. I outlined the angel's body with my white Posca paint pen, which I love. These are so fun for doing the details. Wait until you see what we do on the houses. But just so you could see her really well, and then that'll be okay. We're just going to use that and go for it. Okay, so I'm going to take my clean brush. I'm going to get it wet and blot, like just put water in the bristles, and I'm going to pick up, I don't know if there's, yeah, I have some white paint. Here, let me show you how to make, you know what, you're not going to be able to see it. I'm going to do it on here. I'm going to do it on my craft mat. I'm going to put that paint down. Wait a minute, start over. All right, so that's, I'm going to zoom in. We'll make sure you can see this. All right. I'm going to make a wash right next to this. So I am getting water on my brush, and I am pulling a little bit of that pigment into this. So this is my wash right here. It's like shrinking. That is so funny. I'm going to add a little more water just to make sure that we have enough to cover the whole angel. It is so weird how that's shrinking. All right, and that's my wash. This is so weird. All right, so now I've rinsed my brush off completely. I'm going to zoom back out so I'm not like... But that's what I'm going to paint my angel with. So I'm going to bring her back into the shot. And I have a clean brush. I'm going to go into water, blot, and now I'm just going to load this into my brush. It's loaded, it's in there. See how it's on my brush? And then I'm going to use quick, fast little swipes and cover consistent, is that the right word? So that I don't have more in one place than I do in another. But actually it's definitely, oops, looking different on the canvas than it would on a smooth surface. So it might defeat the purpose a little bit of doing a wash, but I kind of like it. It's looking Once it starts to dry, you can't stick your brush in it anymore because you'll pick up and put a hole in it. But that's basically it. I'm gonna leave it like that. All right, and we'll see if it, see, I'm already, see how I just made those lines? I'm leaving it. I can't touch it. I'm gonna put it down, and that's it. And while that's drying, we're gonna go over back down to our houses, and I'm gonna show you how we do. We're gonna finish up these houses, and I'm gonna use my smallest angle brush. This is a half inch, I think. Nope. I can't even read what it says. 3/8. Blot, go into yellow. I'm gonna get some nice fresh CAD yellow on my palette. And I use a paper plate. I just put it on a paper plate, and then I use a paper palette to blend the color. But I'm gonna do all the windows with a float, just like we did the houses. So I'm corner loading into the yellow, and then I'm gonna just blend that into the bristles of the brush. And I'm gonna start over here. I'm gonna go in a little bit so you can see me. Hopefully I'll stay in the shot. And just do all the left sides. And in the last video, part one, I did undercoat all the windows with just the flesh tan. That's the color that I use to base coat all the houses with too. But it just kind of gives you a cleaner slate than if I was trying to put this on top of blue. It just makes it like a truer color. And listen, this is a mixed media piece. It's not like, I don't even worry about this as much as I did like one of my regular painted pieces that I used to paint all the time, because you have leeway. And I'm outlining everything with my Posca paint pens. I'm gonna do a little bit of like a white trim around the windows, and then we're gonna do black, outline everything in the black. And I happen to have the Posca paint pens that are fine tipped. I have three different sizes I got, and I got those on Amazon. So, all right, so this one has four little windows in it. Like, I put a cross bar in it, so I'm just gonna try and do that as neatly as possible. So that's it. That's all I'm gonna do for them. I mean, if they need a little bit more after, I'll brighten them up, but for right now, that's it. Now, guess what we're gonna do? We're gonna start putting in the details. So I'm pretty excited. I think we're gonna do the black first, and this is what I mean by a Posca paint pen. They literally have paint inside, and it doesn't say anything that I can read to you other than Uni Posca paint pen, because it's all written in Japanese or Chinese. 1M might, and 3.24, that might be what indicates Japan, what indicates the millimeter or size of the pen nib. But I'm just gonna get that started, and it's so fun to use these. I'm just moving so that I can, I don't need to do it all on camera, because it's just gonna take a lot of time. But I am going to go under all my roofs. And when you go over the bumps on this canvas, the paint spatters a little bit, just FYI. So, I mean, it's worth it to take your time. But again, it's a mixed media piece, so it's not like, it can absolutely be part of the design. I did crook it there, and you know, not loving that, but that's what happens. If I'm not sitting right over it, like, it might come out a little wonky. But I'm gonna just do one house for you on camera, and I'll come back with it all done, and then I'll show you how I do the moon, finish up the moon, and then we'll finish up the angel. And then I also add some gold stars to the background and some finishing to the background too. But you can already see how these bright dark lines start to, and I can actually, I think I'm going to add a little bit of the house color under this roof too. So that's basically what I do with the black. And I'll bet you it's going to be, let's go over to the moon, because I will just outline the moon, and it is getting a little caught. And it's good because, you know what's so great about this pen is if I go out of lines or something, I can get it off with a Q-tip because it's a water-based paint pen. So I'm going to give him a little inside of his mouth. So I just put that little line there. Let's see if you can see that. And I'll put a little bit of the red inside of his mouth. Then you give him an eye like this. I like to just go and then put a big pupil. And I'll put a little spot of white. You can even put an eyebrow. And I want to put a little pink cheek, but for now, he's good. What else can we do? I just want to let these dry a little before I go with the white. But I'm going to finish outlining the roof. And I'll show you, I did add a little more shading behind these houses. I'm not sure I'm loving, I think I pulled some of the paint away when I did it with the sponge. I don't know what happened with that, but I do like the glow, but I'm just not sure it came out as well as it could have. Those guys are playing Monopoly, and it's with an English set. My mom was from England. And I'm guessing we got it. I don't remember where it came from. See, that bugs me that that's out of lines. But isn't this just bringing it to life? That's what I was saying in the last video about I could... Oh, I am really being crooked. This bumpy surface is... makes it very hard to steer. All right, I'm gonna stop with that. Then you get the white. And just make sure it's working. Yep, got plenty of paint. And I literally just fill in that little space that I made with the black paint pen. And this is just thick enough that it fills it, but it doesn't go over it. So I still have white, black lines. I also put a little scallop. I forgot about that. I did a scallop under all the red roofs. Turn the piece too, if you need to give yourself a nice straight line. It just makes it easier. But yeah, I did like a small scallop. That's very small, actually. I think my other one was bigger. And I did it under this one. All the red roofs. Did I do it here? And I'm just waiting for some of the black lines to dry before I go in with the white, because it could totally pick it up. It is paint. Like right there, I went very close to the other black line, but When it's dry, I'll be able to sneak this white in there. And then I go and color that in. And really just make a little circle, almost like a straight line and a circle. Because I want the black line to show. I don't want to obliterate it, but it's hard to do on camera because you're not like right over it. See, I obliterated some of that black line. But this is just your own personal preference. Whatever little details you want to add. I just think the white makes it pop so nice. And it's fun. Honestly, guys, I tell you all the time, if it's not fun. Now I'm going to put a little tiny dot on my moon's eye. Just brings him to life. All right, that is looking not too bad. That's not looking too bad. And I'll show you what we're gonna do with her. I'll go away and get some things together. What else did I want to show you on the houses? Oh, I did put a few lines like on this, the red roofs. I did this like a wide line on this one. On this one I did like really thin, this one I did like 4 down lines. This one I went like this. And totally went out of line on that one. I gotta go on that with white too, so. This is kind of boring. There's nothing going on. Oh, don't forget your doorknobs. There's little doorknobs. But basically that's it. You could put any type of like cross hatching type lines for details or no details at all. Like this one, I could put like a little, that's it. That's all he gets. All right, so he's pretty much done. I just want to give him a little bit of a pink cheek, and I think I'm just going to fill in his mouth with like a little bit of that burgundy red. So we're going to come back and focus on this angel when I get back. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So I put her arm on, so I just retraced it. I traced on her arm and outlined it in white so you guys could see it. But we're gonna highlight, shade with midnight blue, the same color that I used to base the bottom, like base the undercoating with. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of that out and really try and be sparing with my smallest angle brush. I just take a bitty bit of paint. I'm walking away from it because I don't want to overwhelm, but I just want to go around her arm and her hand. And I also painted her hand on, and I didn't shade it yet, but I'm gonna add some darkness around her hand. I'm probably gonna outline it. I think I'll use like a my Faber-Castell liner because I don't want it to be too thick. I'm going to do a little bit on her other arm, like to make it look like it's behind her body. So right here, I probably should outline that too. I think, yeah, and then right here, and I think that's about it, really. I think that's all you need. I'm going to spruce it up a little with some white, more white lines. Just darkening it up a little bit more. All right. So you can see that. I'm going to put a little cheek on my moon. Joe, you going up?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you in a bit. Love you too. All right, so I'm putting a little, this is like a bright pink. What is this, bubble gum? Yeah, I always, I love bubble gum. put it, I'm just going to put it right there on his cheek. And sorry, I'm a little far away, but then I'm going to do both of her cheeks, just like right up along the sides. I think I'm going to give her curls. Just want to pink it up a little bit, not too much. Oh, I want to shade her hand. Probably going to touch that. I don't have any wet paint. It's kind of dried out. I don't really want to touch what I did. You know what we'll do? We'll shade the heart. So I'm just going to use this, the darker burgundy color, and go on the left side of the heart. So I stick the corner of the brush. Hopefully it'll be dark enough, but if not, I'll have to add a little. That looks pretty good. I think I'm going to make a ribbon. All right, let's do some hair. What kind of, I want to make some curls. I just have burnt sienna. Maybe I'll throw a little, like, I'll get some yellow out and throw some, maybe I'll do some brush mixing. I'm going to try and get like a really, one of my liner brushes. I don't have very good liner brushes. This is a double aught, a double zero. But they don't really, my bristles are terrible. So I'm going to get some of the burnt sienna on here. And give her some curls. Let's just see how this goes. Some crazy looking curls. And then I'll go over this with the gold. And hopefully it'll look, you know, like hair. I tried the shade underneath, but it might not be as opaque under there. But I'm just going to come back with some yellow. And it's kind of watery, the paint. And I think I'm trying to get it to fill in. And then I'll come back with some really dry paint. And or not dry paint. Well, not as runny. And make the curls more pronounced. But I like the feel of this. It's feeling kind of good. She's got some messy hair. I like that. That looks cute. I'm going to come back, let that dry, and I'll come back and define it a little more. Let's put her halo on. I'm just going to do that in the straight gold. And remember I said you'd do it like a just an oval. So I'm going to do a front and a back. Like that. And then we'll let it dry and I'll come back and define that too. What else did I want to do? I think some more prominent white on the wings. Oh, you know what I didn't do? A line. I think I need to darken. Maybe I'll use Payne's Gray to shade after. But basically, I can actually use Payne's Gray. Let's try the Payne's Gray or the... I don't think this is Payne's Gray. I think this is the Midnight. Yeah, I want to use Payne's. I think it dried up. We ate dinner. It's actually late right now, but I wanted to finish this. I love this piece. I think it's super happy and pretty. And I'm going to add more stars to pop out the sky a little bit. So what am I doing? Oh, Payne's Gray. Yeah, I'm going to use this to shade my heart. So I'm going to take it in. It's too dark. I'm going to try and like calm it down a little. It's not bad. And then I should use like neon, a neon red. There's a cool color called Hot Shots Fiery Red. But I think, since I don't have it on my desk, I'm just going to use some of the red plus white and like highlight the other side. Oh, maybe with a little pearl. Yeah, I think a little red plus pearl would make it What do you think? That would be cute. All right. So I'm just going to put it on this side of the heart and there a little bit. I like it. All right. So then we're going to have to connect that with a ribbon. What color ribbon should I make? A blue ribbon? Let me do the Payne's Gray since I have the Payne's Gray out. I'm going to show you how what a difference this will make if I shade. It's just going to make everything stand out more. What else do I want to tell you guys? I think that's it. So basically, I'm going to add stars to the sky. We'll do that. I'm going to add a face to her. But look how much that's popping. Oh, I got to do it on the wing again. Just up against her back. And then, what else? You got, let's go over her hair again. So maybe if I even use this like shading flesh, this might be a good, so she's got like three colors of hair, but I want to try and make this as delicate. I have this really, really, I'm going to have to invest in a good, look at this brush. Wait, can you see? Look at it. It's a mess. I have this one. 20/0. It's thin. All right, I'm going to use that one. And I don't want the paint too watery, but you want it to basically just like run off the bristles like ink. That's the idea. So we'll see how it goes. Let me zoom in. I think this is going to be too light of a color. But I'm just going to, oops, as I try not to stick my hand in the wet paint, just make like curly Q lines. Oh, that's pretty. I like curly hair. Mine's just frizzy now. So that's one of the things, the worst things I hate about getting older is my hair is so different than it used to be. It's not the worst thing in the world, but it's just an adjustment. Cute. She kind of looks like a redhead. I think I gotta add a little more brown of the dark brown on top of that. And then, I mean, if I played with this more, I would know what I'm doing. But for right now, I'm just having fun. Seeing what happens. This is actually, I'm going to shape her face a little, like go around the edges of her face to kind of really get it to there. I like that. I think it filled in pretty good. It definitely looks like she has curly hair. I like it. All right, you know what else I have to do? I have that color out, but I need to shade her hand, her other hand. Just put a little bit of this up against her wrist. This hand got really weird colored. I think I probably got blue on it. And then I'll show you how, like, I think I'm going to use, actually, oh, you know what we could do? This is, like, such detailed stuff, but on the halo, because you don't need to do this. Just going to put like a little bit of the burnt sienna right here. Am I in the shot? And right here. So it makes it look like that's behind. And then I'll take the gold. It's kind of empty. And I can make a gold, nah, the gold ribbon won't show up. I think I gotta make like a blue ribbon or something. Let's see, where's my little, I'll use this one. And just put gold and cute. I'm gonna do, let's leave her alone for a minute, although I want to show you one more thing. Do I have fresh white out now? I gotta find it. Okay. I kind of pushed all my paints back because, anywho, I'm gonna do a couple strokes, and these are just, I think I'm gonna use like my number, what number do I want to use? This is a number 2 round brush, and I'm just getting water on my brush. I'm gonna load it with white, and we're gonna make some strokes on her wings to kind of make it look like a little feathery. Oh, that doesn't look feathery, does it? I need to treat myself to some good brushes. These are cheap, I think. I am pretty cheap. Like, I try to not spend a lot of money, but yeah, I don't love them. But they are what they are. I'm gonna put some here. Just darken this up. Yeah, this brush is like, I don't know, I can't explain it, but I can tell it's just cheesy, like the way it holds a point. But that like just added a little flair. I could put a little bit on the top too. Like, how about try and do this one. Push down and then pick up as I come over. And I'll put 2 right there. So that looks kind of good. And then you can take a liner and make, not like really pleats, but kind of like folds, or I don't know, just some type of movement lines, I guess you would call them, like that. And she needs a line right here, and so I think, you know, like at her neck, we could do like just a little couple of dots for a collar. Maybe a little wider over there. I widened her her arms, both of her arms, like they in my drawing, they were actually, see how I like widened it? I don't know why, I just like the idea of it hanging down. Basically, I think that's it for that. And then I need to do a ribbon. So for the ribbon, I just have to think of what color I want to do the ribbon. I'm going to outline the heart. See, look at this. That was even coming apart. What color do I want to do the ribbon? Guys, you're not here to help me. Yellow. I could use yellow. I think I'll use yellow, because you know what, the yellow covers, and I can, maybe I'll throw some gold on it too, but the yellow covers pretty well, like it's, this CAD yellow is pretty opaque. Oh, I just ran it right through the, it's not exactly yellow, because I ran it through. So I'm going to start inside of her hand, right here, push down and pick up right kind of there, and then start at the bottom of her hand, and kind of connect it to the top so it looks like it goes behind. And I mean, that's all I have to do. I could make it like a ribbon or a bow, but I think I'm just going to leave it like that. Put, like, how about we put a dip dot of, why do I have black out now? Payne's gray would look fine. Right here. That's kind of big, but that's okay. I mean, now she needs a face, right? I don't know, like, makes me nervous. I kind of want to put, draw it on with, I'm going to let it sit for a minute, and then I'll think about that. We'll put on some more stars. We'll put on some of these stars. Let's put, I want them to be, like, yellow gold. So I'm going to mix a little bit of yellow and gold on a sponge and see what that gives me. Where's the gold? So that they're kind of gonna be a little more visible. We'll see. Have to see what happens. So again, this is just the cut and dry. I'm gonna try not to have a ton of paint on here like I did for the other stuff. But You know me, that's not my way. And I'm gonna try and pounce and not make a mess and really actually get the star shape on there, but who knows. Let me zoom out a little bit for this, because I can't really see what I'm doing, I guess, huh? Sorry. But yeah, I'm just pouncing with not as much paint, and I hope it works. Let's see. Yeah, I mean, they're good enough. I'm gonna put some over here, like so. Am I in the shot? So yeah, this is cad yellow and the metallic gold mixed on a sponge. Oh, I don't want to get them on her necessarily. Near her would be okay. I like it. It definitely makes the sky pop, right? Gotta put some around him. Let's just keep going. See, then I got it right on him. Then I start to pull like this. Instead of doing the up and down, I start to go like swipey. And that's how it gets under the stencil and it totally gets blobby. But I don't have as much paint on there, so it should be okay. I didn't want to get him. I wanted him to stay. So that looks cute, right? Those stars. I think that's a nice finishing touch. I need a couple more. Maybe I'll bring a few down. I'm not sure that I love the glow. And then on this one, I made it like a snowy night. That was like a different one I did. But I think I'm gonna leave that off. I could probably just do white dots, but I think these are looking good. So basically that's it, guys. I can I gotta get her face on there for you and show you how I do that, but I mean, I'm tempted to just do nothing, like keep it really basic, like not even put I want to get like a biggish one right here, and like here, I gotta put a couple. And a couple small ones. I think that looks good. Alright, what kind of face should I do? I wish you were here to tell me. I like it. All right, stop. I'm going to stop and just do like, I'm going to draw it on. I'm going to zoom in. We're just going to go for it. I'm going to try and keep it simple and do like, a line on the bottom. She's kind of, how about that? How about I have her eyes closed? That looks good. And how about just a little smile? Oh Lord, that does not look like, oh, that's good. It's a tiny little face. How about eyebrows? Does that look like her eyes are closed, or should I open them? I could open them. I like them closed. Oh no, now they're, okay, look, that's, I mean, it's the smallest face you ever saw. How about a little chin? And another, oh dear, I don't want to get carried away. That's it. Oops, can you see it? I think I'm going to put a tiny little white dot with my gel pen, because that always makes the eyes come to life, right? I don't know if I can even make, I'm going to put like a bottom lip on her too. See, I get carried away and then it's too late. But I'm going to take this little bit of pink and just put it like Oh, look at my brush. I'm gonna use this brush. Look at that brush. Same thing. But this is pretty much it, you guys. I think it would be cute if she... There, it looks kind of cute. Can you see that? I like it. All right, I think we're done. You know what? I can add a little gold while I have... I have gold out here. I'm going to add it to the ribbon. I have a ton on my brush. And hopefully I don't... Yep, there it went. I knew it was going to drip down. And that looks cute. All right, I should sign it, right? Shouldn't I sign it? Let's put my name somewhere on here. S-A-R-A. Did I get it? All right, I appreciate you hanging in there with me. Oh my gosh. I'm tired. I think I'm tired. Let me zoom back out and show you the finished thing. Hopefully, yeah, it wasn't too long. I tried to chop it up into enough pieces that it wasn't overwhelmingly long. I think it turned out cute. I enjoyed it, and I just wanted to share it with you guys because I know I haven't been posting a lot lately, and I felt like doing something different. So, I think, oh guys, I got, let me show you this. All right, so there it is. I could darken up a little bit around her head or something, I don't know. I think it's cute. I might put it in a frame. I should put it in a frame, it's cute. So there's that, but look what I got. I got pewter, and I ordered the book. Here's the book, Metal Embossing, and I've been seeing some cool videos on the subject, and I am going to be playing. Think I want to try and do a journal cover. There's some patterns in here. This is an old book, and I wish there's an artist that I would love her to make write a book. I like this bird. I might do the birdie because that's really cute and it has feathers. So anywho, I'm going to be playing around with this, and like you can do light switch covers. So I have this. I'm waiting for my tools. Of course, the tools are the last thing to come. So, but I mean, it came, this came with just a wooden thing, and you can use ball tools and stuff to emboss. But I got that, so that's coming up. But yeah, I just felt like painting, and I think it's super cute. Right? I didn't outline the heart. I can outline the heart. That's like, well, I can outline a lot of stuff. But yeah, that really pops when you outline. That looks good. All right. That's it, you guys. Thanks for watching. Okay, I'm back. 1 second. I just want to show you, I did put stickles, and see, that's what the fun part about mixed media is. You can add all these other media. So I put a little of this Dimensional Magic on the moon and on the windows so that they'll shine like glass. And then of course I added glitter, not glitter, but stickles, what is it, gel pen, the glitter gel pen to her hair. I should do something to the heart too. You know what I'm gonna do? Just put some clear Wink Estella on there, and but then it's done. Yeah, because I put, what else I put? Oh, stickles, like on some of the stars, I put stickles so they're actually like glistening, like they're, oh my gosh, I see them. And I shaded along the bottom and just really spruced it up. I'm not crazy about the glow. Like, I wish I would have floated it on now, because it, for some reason, I think I pulled it off in the middle and it kind of is just sitting up there. I think I would have had more control if I would have floated it, but all in all, I think it's a super cute project. Oh, I put stickles on her wing. And I like added heavier floating on the bottom of her dress and on her arms, both arms. Oh, I outlined her hair with some black pen so that you can like, it kind of filled in. What else did I do? See, that's all the finishing touch type details. So I'm just gonna put this on the heart. Even though the heart is already like, it's got pearl paint on it. Oops, kind of went out of the lines. That'll just make it a little more spruced up. And that I'm going to call done. And I ended up signing it with my paint pen, which why wouldn't I do that? It's so much easier. But I think that's cute, right? So the stickles just on a few of the stars in certain places look so cute. All right, so now it's done. What else? Oh, I told you I put the Dimensional Magic all over the moon and the windows. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.